And whether you preach now, let me tell you a quick story, won't cost you nothing. I had a father who started out as a pastor, decided waiting on the promises of God got a little too hard, so he took the fast route to management. Did his own thing, if you will, fell away from the Lord. Ended up with a 150-year prison sentence. 18 years in, he was dying on his deathbed. You know what his words were? To every guard, to every chaplain, to everybody that come in the prison cell, you know what his words were? Hey, do you know Jesus? Hey, can I tell you about the Lord? I don't have much time. Can I tell you about Jesus? You'll preach it now or you'll preach it then, but you will preach it, because every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. You will do it. Whether you do it in the comfort of your home or, God forbid, on your final resting bed, you shall proclaim the good news, because it's what you were meant to do. Poor Zacharias is continually mute. All the little women of the village, here comes the baby. This was a patriarchal society. If you know what that means the daddies had the naming rights. And I have to tell you, with current events, I may not be against it. The daddies picked strong names in the family. We pick names like Tadashna Jones. You know what I'm saying? We've got a little carried away in our society. We pick things that Harvard can't spell. So it might would have been better if we just let the men go back to it. Hallelujah. So Elizabeth speaks up. She says, my man can't speak, I'ma speak. This is why it's important to have a good thing. This is why it's important to have a wife who's equally yoked, or a husband that's equally yoked. Because if my man's voice goes dry, I can tell you I know his heart well enough to go, uh-uh, Howard Bell won't do that. My man won't do that. No, no, we named our promise. It's yielded life. We're going to preach it here, there, and everywhere, and every door that opens up, whether it looks like the gates of hell or the palaces, we're going in. But see, if you don't have that, if you don't have that, somebody will pervert the promise. And so Elizabeth says, listen, we're going to name this baby John. And the women said, you can't. So sorry, you can't. Because you don't have any males in your family with that name. And tradition says it's got to be done. Come on. It's a clear day, land. Tradition says it's got to be done this way. If we don't do a 30-minute sermon, we're in error.